I don't really remember the first time I heard Don Williams, because for me it feels like he's always been in our house. My dad had, I think ultimately 13 Don Williams albums, and that was the music I heard more than any other artist in our house.
No more nights, sleeping alone.
There's a tear in his voice, there's a cry in it, there's something that draws you to it.
It's such a hopeful voice. It's like everything good, everything figured out, everything kind. It's just like nothing else.
Imagine how sweet it be.
Oh, I never imagined I'd be doing it for 2 or 3 years. You're absolutely among the most blessed in the world if you can make a living at whatever you love to do.
But all I can do is imagine that.
Don's really a great interpreter of emotion, really, without trying to sell you on it. He just lays it out there and states it in such an honest way.
No more silence in the hall.
I always had more faith in other people's writing than I did my own. He got me squared away on that several times, but he'd say, "No, Don, that's really a fine song. We need to address that, you know." But I always found more pleasure, really, in recording other people's songs.
She doesn't mean to seem so cold. He's just asking for a dance.
It's called "I Just Come Here for the Music," and it's a love story of someone who's been through heartbreak and he's trying to start something up again. And then in that quest, the lady that he's approaching, has the same story.
I just come here for the music. I get lost here in the sound.
The emotion of it and the clarity of the characters is just overwhelming to me. And I know that's the reason I wanted to record it is number one, it's very, very well written. The interest is just of what's transpiring is just awesome.
Imagine how sweet it'd be to have you here.
I had the pleasure of sitting down with Keith when he first moved to town. He was a huge Don Williams fan. I mean, I figured that out right away.
To get to spend a day in the Sound Emporium with Garth and with Don, it was amazing.
The neatest part about working on this record was, it was so peaceful. You hear it and you go, oh, thank you. Somebody's not yelling at me. Somebody's not in my face. It was just beautiful, magnificent.
I don't know who you could compare as you couldn't say someone like Don Williams, because there is no one.
I put the headphones on, I'm singing, Don's over there singing, and it was like getting to walk on the moon. It was that surreal.
It's the perfect combination. Garth at the helm, Garth Fundis at the helm, Don singing a great song, you can't go wrong.
But all I can do is imagine.